What's up, everybody? SC Survival and Hunting here. Today we're coming at you with another video. We are doing a torture test on a drawstring bag that Military Luggage Company sent us. As you can see, their logo right there. Military Luggage Company is a awesome company. Not just because they sent us this, but they're just nice and they have a huge selection of bags everywhere. We'll put the link to their Facebook and their website so you can go buy some stuff, and then while you're at it, like their Facebook page. All right, and also on the website, this thing says it's tough as nails. So we're gonna see if it's tough as nails. We're gonna put this thing to the test. We're gonna try to bring out his weaknesses. And if you're wondering, if you want one at the end of this video, it's $10 online. We'll send a link to that too. All right, so let's get started, and we're gonna move this table out the way real quick.
Also, just to let you know, this bag is made out of 600D construction material for your bag. It is very strong, very durable stuff. And it is made out of some thick nylon straps right here. These straps are very thick. Also, the dimensions on this are 16 inches by 13 and a half inches, if I remember correctly. It has a side zipper on it right here. Opens up the side. Also, another thing I noticed, it has the extra zippered pocket on the very inside, which is really nice. I have yet to find a very decent drawstring bag with zippered pockets, which is good. It's hard to pull together, which is good. That means it's a tough construction.
And there's tension between it. Not tension, but it's not all loose.
Yes. And so if you give us a second, we are going to get set up, and we will go ahead and begin our torture test. Well, we got everything moved and we are ready and set up for our torture test. I just wanted to go ahead and point out what exactly we're going to be doing here. But before I get started on that, I wanted to tell you just how great this bag is. I mean, as soon as you can pick it up, you can feel, wow, this is a good bag. This is not going to break. I've gone through probably 5 or 6 different drawstring bags of many different companies. Especially Nike. I think the Nike Elite drawstring bag, I've heard some people say that is very good. It's only like $50 or something. I used it a couple weeks, broke. I think every single drawstring bag I've had has broken. But so far this one, we put so much stuff through it and in it that it's been pretty good.
Well, shoot, we've tried out all the brands, Nike, Adidas, just regular other hunting drawstring bags.
Under Armour,
they're just so flimsy. This thing just feels
solid.
That is definitely a plus one that I'm giving to Military Luggage Company. If they're just like with the bag we're giving away, that is well built, and it's only a $50 bag. You get stuff like the Rush 72, which is almost $200, and the material, I would put it neck to neck with it.
Yes.
And see which one would break first.
Definitely.
And my money so far would be on this material right here, the 600D, whatever they're using in it. Because all it said was material. I'm not sure if it's polyester, ballistic nylon, polypropylene, or whatever, all that crazy stuff.
But they do know how to make a good bag. So, we're going to go ahead and start our torture test. Now, in their description below this bag, it says it is tough as nails. So, we're going to find out just how tough it really is. And then, at the end of it, we're going to take a real nail, and we're going to beat it and see just how bad it does. But we have this log right here, this big log. We are planning, what exactly were we doing with this one?
We're just going to drop it on it.
Oh, yeah. We're just going to drop it on it. And then the next one, this weight, 35-pound weight.
Let me pause you there. We're going to drop it on, not drop it like the little girl. Drop it and let it fall in there. I'm going to actually get some momentum and get the edge right on it and see what happens.
Yes.
And then let's see how good the logo stands up to where we can put the bag on the rough part of the surface of the log and scrape back and forth and see how that holds up.
And then we're going to put the 35-pound weight. Well, first we're going to drop the 35-pound weight after we drop the log. Then we're going to put it inside and we're going to start swinging it around and see if these strings here break.
Muscle man. See if I can do this. I'm going to put either this dumbbell in there or another log, and I'm going to pick it up by the straps and fling it as high as I can in the air. And let it drop down and see what happens there. We'll see how that goes.
And then if that still has not done anything to it, we're going to take two of these knives. This is the Kershaw Clash. We've done a review on that. And then this is the Smith & Wesson M&P knife. I'm not sure if we've done a review on that or
we
not.
We haven't.
We haven't. Okay. Anyway, those are two very good knives. Very sharp. Good point. We're going to pick them up, drop them at chest level simultaneously, and see if they can penetrate this material. Then if that does not fail,
We're going to grab one of us is going to grab both sides like this, and we're going to put quite a bit of our weight on it and pull against each other, basically tug of war.
With the 35-pound weight in there.
And see if the tension causes the bottom to snap out, any other straps to snap, or to rip at the top at the seams.
And then after that, we're going to work on the zippers on the inside. I was noticing it as we started the review. The inside looks a little flimsy. It does not look as strong as this or feel as strong as this other material. So we're going to be doing a lot of work with the zippers, trying to see if we can get those to break. So if you will give us a second, we will cut the video and we will get everything into position. Excuse me.
All right, now we have the dumbbell in there, and as you can see those little rips? There's rips in it. Just the two stab marks right there.
And the heavy side or the bottom side of the dumbbell is right on the crack. So,
we're going to shake it up and down and see if it rips even more. So if it doesn't rip, you're honestly good if you rip it on accident.
And just give me a second, I'm going to throw it.
Come on, big boy. Ooh, man. Let's see if it ripped at all.
Nope, sure didn't rip.
That is awesome, okay? Knives may have went through it, but look, if you put 35 pounds in it and it's metal and there's already a compromise in the bag itself and you're not getting any more rips, this is a drawstring bag to get. All right, so now we're going to do our part where we pull both sides. And I'm going to set up the frame right here.
And we're going to cut it so we can go get everything into position. Okay, well, now we're going to do the pulling apart test.
All right, so let's see it pulling. We're putting a lot of weight on it. I don't know if you can see it in the frame.
Oh, gosh, you're about to pull me over here.
But I'm basically pulling a lot of my weight into it. I'm a big boy. Trying to pull it in. Nothing. Do you feel anything on it?
Nope.
Now,
The place where I thought it would have snapped or broken was right here, around the seams and the holder where the straps
are. Hold it right there real quick. Let's see if we can get that in the frame. Yep. All right, so how about this? All right, so you pull it tight on the straps. On the straps just at the top. Pull a little bit lower. I'm going to take my knife and see if you barely run it on it, if it'll cut.
Awesome.
So let's see. I mean, I'm not putting a lot of force into it, but I'm putting some. Cutting a tiny bit, not much. Let's see if you can see that.
I wouldn't have even noticed it if you hadn't pointed it out.
So here, let's zoom in a little bit. I mean, there's literally nothing there, and I was trying a little bit. So let's do it a little bit harder. See if it does it. Now, I actually put a good bit of force in that. Not a lot.
Barely,
not much.
Barely touched it.
So now...
Wait. Would you like to do another test of scraping off? See if we can scrape off the logo.
Oh, yeah.
The logo.
Let's see if how good the logo coating is on here. So I'm going to take the serrations. There's a little bit of, there's some abrasion, some of the coating came off, as you can see. But nothing that will compromise the bag. There's a tiny bit of cuts up here. But nothing that will compromise the bag that you think would,
no.
Would it.
Now one thing I want to do is see if these zippers are going to break. Now, I'm going to be pulling down on this, and I'm expecting this to tear or something.
Actually, pull down as hard as
yes.
You can and try to, you can rip it.
Yeah, I'm actually going to try to rip this. Nothing.
All right, now let's see if I can do it.
There you go.
All right. Good God. This thing is...
That's crazy. I don't think... Well, there you go. I think after a lot of force...
I put literally almost all my strength into that pull right there.
Lucky there. And we have just ripped that off. And I think one part went this way, one part went the other, but I got most of it.
Okay, so basically, you can do whatever you want with these zippers. I tried to break it. Whenever you're using this just everyday use, you're not going to be trying to break it. Hey, I put my wallet in here. Let's see if I can break it so then it'll fall out. No, that's not your mindset. See, just it didn't just snap right off it. It took a lot of force. I mean, you saw my buddy over here pulling on it, and it didn't work. You saw me over here for like 10 seconds not do anything. So, Military Luggage Company? Yes. Now, one thing that I would point out to this, honestly, the price, you cannot beat, okay? $9.95. Other drawstring bags that are 50 bucks break with a log dropped on it, or tear. So, one thing that I do want to say, Military Luggage Company, if this is not, like, if this is only single stitched, like right here, to make this thing indestructible where you couldn't do anything with it, like triple or quadruple stitch this. Do you know how hard that would be to break this? Yo, zippers are wonderful, even though I pulled that one off. That's just because I tried with all my might. I mean, I tried with a lot of force. And so I think that one would do the same.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to go ahead and break another one.
And one last final thing. I'm just going to go run this down right in the middle. I'm going to put a little bit of force on it. I just want to see if my knife is sharp enough to do this.
Or really how well the material stays.
Yeah, either one.
Let's see. So I'm going to hold it just like that.
There you go. But that is a super sharp knife.
It cut it. Right down the middle. But I mean, that's because we poked it and then went down with it.
Hey, there you go. I wanted to cut it. I mean, if we're going to torture this thing. But hey, I had to go put almost all my might, and this is a super sharp blade.
Alright, so I'm going to do a little wrap up. This bag, you couldn't ask for anything better. Like I said, definition of a torture test, we were trying to rip this thing up. Okay? You saw in the beginning of the video, those are going to be practical stuff with all your stuff in it. It didn't break or anything at all. Now see, once you start getting sharp weapons involved, that's when it's going to tear. But that isn't what this is designed for. This isn't Kevlar, okay? This is designed to hold a crap load of stuff and not break, which it did. 35 pounds in this tiny little bag.
And just so you know, if you would have taken the Rush 72 bag, that's what, $250, something like that?
No, it's more like $190 to $200.
Well, anyway, if you would have taken a knife and done that exact same thing, it would have ripped the same way. I guarantee you.
Any material, shoot, I've taken knives and cut wires like that, and that's copper. This isn't made of copper. Copper's a metal, obviously, and this is, but this material right here, SC Survival approved. I'm going to go personally buy a couple more just so I could have a couple around the house. I love these things. I totally approve these things. I mean, literally, honestly, there's nothing Besides, if this thing isn't double or triple stitched, like quadruple stitch it. Because then it's going to take a lot more force to rip it with a knife or cut it. So you couldn't ask for anything better. The strings still feel good even though they're totally wiped out. This thing is just awesome. Thanks, Military Luggage Company, for sending us this. This is a awesome product. Awesome. A plus, A plus, A plus. So guys, thanks for watching. SC Survival here. Check out Military Luggage Company. We're out.